the Vegas Golden Knights are in New York, the New York area, all week long. And joining us now from the NHL store in New York City, Jonathan Marchessault. Jonathan, thank you for joining the show. We appreciate your time. I got to ask, I know you guys flew in last night. Do you have plans for your week in New York City outside of the games? And did you get up to anything last night?
No, not really. I think we just had a nice team dinner all together. It was actually fun to have time and enjoy our time in New York, and it's a fun time of the year to be in New York, I think.
Yeah, no question about that. Around the Christmas season, it is a lot of hustle and bustle in Manhattan, so be careful of who you're going to bang into, because there's a lot of walking around on the street. I want to ask you about the offseason for you guys, because so many people say, you know, you get to the Stanley Cup final, and then before you know it, you're back at training camp again. Did you find that it was a really short offseason?
Yeah, it was definitely a short offseason, but I mean, it's part of the game. And I mean, obviously, we went far last year and a disappointing result, but it's part of the game, and you need to find a way to be ready right off the start. And I think as a team, we were a little sloppy, but we definitely picked it up the past few games.
Jonathan, I love your story. When you look at the history, what you've done, it's really quite remarkable. You were 25 years old when you really kind of broke into this league and broke through. I have a couple of questions. Did you ever doubt yourself, number one, as a young hockey player? And number two, who gave you that first opportunity, the person that really first believed in you when you said, wow, I think I can really make something special out of this?
Yeah, I never doubted myself. I think I was a pretty confident kid growing up. I just needed that one chance that's going to make you an NHL player. And I mean, the first, obviously in Tampa, I started playing in the NHL, but the first real chance that I was able to play as the style of player I am was in Florida when unfortunately one of my good friends, Huberto, went down. I was put by Gerard Gallant on the first line with Barkov and Jagr. And I think it's where it all started for me.
You mentioned the start of the season. The team played a little bit sloppy to start the year, but you guys are on a roll now. What do you think is the key to the Vegas Golden Knights game in terms of reaching the success that you guys aim to?
Obviously, Flower, when he's in the net, we're lucky to have him. I mean, you have a chance to win every night. He's an amazing goalie. He kept us in every game this year, and it's awesome. And also, I think we got to give credit to our the line that Eakin, Tuck, and Pacioretty are playing. I think they're playing big hockey for us right now, and it's definitely fun to watch.
Jonathan, you guys went through something that was so special and so amazing last year for an expansion team to come together and get all the way to the Stanley Cup final. Did you take a moment this summer to look back on what you guys accomplished as a group? Because I know from afar, it was amazing to watch.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, there's always positive in every situation. Obviously, a lot of positive last year, but at the end, we're all playing hockey to win the game, and we lost in the finals. So obviously, for my part, it's like a little disappointed, but it's time to move on. There's a new season going right now, and we need to focus on that, I think.
Jonathan, obviously there was a lot of great things that happened last year, and maybe it didn't finish up quite the way you wanted. But this year, at the start of the season, I spoke to George McPhee this morning a little bit about it. And in my opinion, I felt like it looked like, as a club, you guys maybe weren't as prepared for what the onslaught would be from opponents now that you had raised the level of awareness about Vegas. Did you feel any of that, or what would you say was the reason for the slow start?
I think we're a hard-working team. That's how we win games, and I think we just weren't working hard enough at the beginning of the year. I think we're a little sloppy, a little lazy, and the teams are ready. And right now in the NHL, every night you don't know who's going to win. I think that's the quality of the league is right now, and it's pretty fun to be in. And I think you need to be ready, because every night, like if you're not, I think the other teams always have some high-quality players, and they're going to make you pay.
We see proof of that every night, too, in this league. There's so many one-goal games every single night. It just shows that the difference between a good team and a mediocre team really isn't that different. But you guys are rolling now, Jonathan. We appreciate your time. Before I let you go, though, I got to ask, what happened to the Lamborghini?
Yeah, we love the Lamborghini.
Yeah, I mean, when you lose in the Stanley Cup Finals, you got to give the Lambo back.
Oh, no!
That's the way it went. That's in the fine print, I guess.
Yeah. Always at the bottom of the page.
Yeah.
How'd you like driving that thing around?
Oh, it drives really well. obviously, it drives really well, but I mean, I think it just wasn't for me.
All right, well, listen, enjoy your time in New York City. It's one of the craziest times of year in the Big Apple with the holiday season, and we appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you very much.